Good afternoon. Happy Memorial Day. Right now I'm in Wilmina, Oregon. Just heading out for a ride in the woods with my brother Isaac. Just a beautiful day out. So right now Isaac's behind me on the Beta 390. The street legal version, obviously, the RR-S. Definitely a wonderful bike, but certainly biased towards the dirt and off-road. Really, it's just a street legal dirt bike. And right now I'm riding my Norden 901, the Husqvarna bike. And this is definitely biased more towards the street, but can do some, you know, I'll say non-paved road stuff. And, you know, you could probably do some single track that is, you know, not very rough, but this is a big bike. I mean, it's, you know, it's not like the bigger GS bikes, but I think it weighs in the neighborhood of 470 pounds. And it's pretty well balanced, you know, like it doesn't, yeah, a lot of the weight is down low, but still, it's just, it's a handful when you get in rough stuff. And I'm still becoming familiar with how to maneuver the bike in the rough stuff with the least amount of effort possible. I'm sure the bike is much more capable than my riding right now. So we're kind of heading from Wilhelmina, we're heading west. And there's a OHV area out here with a bunch of trails, but there's also just miles of gravel road, so it's a good place to go explore. And, you know, I've been kind of intermittently coming out to this area for years, and I still really don't know it that well. Probably because most of my riding out here has been on a, you know, on a dirt bike. And while you can ride the gravel roads, you know, legally on a non-street legal dirt bike, it just kind of seems like when I was riding out here before, we were sticking to the same trails and all that stuff. So I will say, on the street, this Norden 901 is, it's a really comfortable bike, really easy to ride, feels pretty stable going around corners, well balanced. Nice, fairly linear power, I'd say. It's got decent torque, but I'd say you do have to rev it a little bit to really feel the juice, so to speak. But I think it's rated at 105 horsepower. So for a bike that's only 470 pounds, that's pretty good, you know. they've got this section, this road on the right closed. I think they're doing some logging up there. That's the that's one of the staging areas for the OHV park. Hopefully they open that back up for folks in the future. That would be good. But what we'll do is we'll go up here. There's a kind of a trail or a very rough, unmaintained road. We'll take a ride up here and go down that, and then go check out that staging area. Take a ride up here. Apparently you can get to Beaver if you go left there. I love Beaver. So if we go this way, I think we can go back and basically go to that OHV staging area, and this obviously isn't closed, so still got Isaac with me, that's good. A couple tire tracks from, looks like a dirt bike maybe. A few small branches there. Yeah, this bike, I mean, I definitely need to get used to standing up, going through rough stuff. I think it's just gonna ultimately be a lot easier, probably even safer, you know. I'm standing up right now. Holy, some big whoops there. I can hear Isaac back there. He's having fun giving it a little gas, going over some of the little whoops there. Yeah, so they're definitely doing some logging activity here. Came up here a while back, went up this road. It looks a little muddy, so we'll go up there. Holy crap, holy. This is getting really muddy. Made it through that anyway. Holy moly. Yeah, there's a lot of branches back there in the roadway, if you can call this a road. This was at one time a well, this isn't a road anymore, this is a trail. But holy shit, I guess we'll go down it. Well, we got trees growing in the middle of the trail. Holy crap! You pick.